Does seem very extreme to me, and it seems to me that it comes from a fundamental misunderstanding about the culture and psychology behind video games. For example, we know that there are benefits to playing, and benefits that actually boost well-being, you could say. But then we also know that overplaying video games can kind of do the opposite for us. Just off the top of my head. Server congestion. So everybody trying to log on at the exact same time might cause some big issues. Esports is an enormous industry, especially in China, and they need to train to be able to compete, and it's going to be outside of those hours. I don't know what's going to happen there. That's going to be a wait and see, I guess.
Yeah, there's a lot of people in the industry who worry that if, for example, we don't have youth playing games, then, well, number one, there's a concern that maybe there's going to be less adult gamers a few years from now. But also, where is the talent going to be from the pool of players going to practice esports? Because typically, to be world class, you really have to start very young, as you would have to do any other athletic event. So that is definitely a concern. I don't think any of us have any answers yet because the regulations are so new.
You need to understand the motivation of why they play. Some people are playing to cope because life's really, really tough, and there's stress, there's mental health stuff, there's anxiety, whatever it is. Some play to be creative, some play to connect with their friends, some play for competition. If we don't have parents, schools, gamers, and even clinicians all on the same page, speaking the same language, and seeing it from a gamer's perspective, you won't get past the first obstacle, which is the resistance. Like, you need buy-in to be able to convince them of anything you want to teach them. So I think that starting in schools is a place to be.